Hello, show.
And I'm Pixel Cheesecake. You're watching another lovely episode of Gaming with Shala.
Today we're playing a game I've never played, another game I've never played before. Excitebike 64.
I found like one of those portable console things. Excitebike is my nephew's first ever video game. He loves it.
Assuming this is multiplayer. Character.
The riders are lined up at the starting gate and ready to go.
I guess Fort Mates was still. I guess right. Lesson one, don't accelerate into the corner. Still in first place. Get it?
I've honestly forgotten how very snap turn this is.
I've never played this place as previously.
GG?
Does she look like an appropriate concept art?
Shala totally not looking up what Vicky Steele looks like.
giving me nothing.
These were the Excitebike characters from the comics from Nintendo Power. They were who you were racing against in the first one. If.
Well, it hasn't brought up any pictures of her, but it has brought up Markiplier.
Huh. Interesting. Let's see how you do. No.
You assholes.
She loses season points for it, so.
How do I lose points for people riding to me? There's a way to, like, maneuver the bike midair.
Yep. Anytime you're on the ground, speed it up, and you can let it go.
You haven't told me how to maneuver it yet.
It...
Okay, how am I supposed to look over at you when I'm looking at the screen? Tell me verbally.
The left side stick.
Okay.
When you're on the ground, press A to speed up. And when you're in the air, you don't need to hit A as hard as all that. I would say try something with high cornering.
There's only two female characters playing.
You hear that, artist? Get on that sh-
The riders are lined up at the starting gate and ready to go. 3, 2, 1, go! And it's Sarah Sugarhill with the hole shot. Jim Rivers is in second place. Sarah Hill has the lead. The Rad Rats. Sarah Hill continues to lead the race.
Well, at least you made lap time. I definitely did not.
Catching up to each other when there's a bunch of bumps in the road.
Jim Rivers is behind the leader.
Neither of us knows absolutely.
They fixed the map.
Okay.
Sarah Hill continues to lead the race.
It sounds like a bad thing.
Well, they kind of... There was a way you could do that and just clip through the entire map. It was hilarious. You'd have to go the wrong way for a little bit, but you would be cutting down lap time to almost zero.
Is that the reason why you're so far behind me?
Me not trying to see how they fix the map. Could have any power set, 3 to 5 powers, but one weakness for 3 powers. What powers would you choose?
Pick a healing power, a shapeshift power. Teleportation skill.
Sarah Hill moves up. Nice. What weaknesses would you choose if you had to?
Rotations. You got the hiccups.
I'll be fine.
Weakness on the healing spell is that it would take stamina to do it. Shapeshifting ability would have the rotation that I can only shapeshift into something that is equal to or less than my current mass. Unless I like have like a organic material to absorb while shapeshifting. Teleportation skill limitation would be that it has a cooldown.
Yeah. I'd want a healing factor that shapeshifting and energy manipulation. Kind of the way energy vampires work in what we do in the shadows for the energy manipulation. But I would choose the downside to the energy vampire.
That'd be really boring.
Need energy to survive. Mm-hmm. But if I'm interesting, I can't get any energy off of anyone. Like, you got a black eye, how did that happen? Well, some guy who I accidentally bumped into turned around and punched me in the face. Wow, that's interesting. See, I can't get energy off of that. You know,
first two abilities, because I guess healing is always needed, like a story. Shapeshifting is always fun.
I feel like any and all shapeshifting would be magic in nature if I chose it. So,
And
the caveat to the magic would be the ability to be counterspelled or forced back into my original form using, or worse, another form through a stronger magic user. So yeah, I would
stronger just magic user like forces you to take on the shape of a wanted killer.
Basically.
Bobby
Ugh. Still map. That's a map glitch for you.
Seems to be trying these, trying for these map glitches, even though I keep going ahead of you with traditional means.
Yep. So we traveled to Colorado, Houston, now Florida. We've been everywhere, man. We've been everywhere, man.
Looking at Bobby Big Dog and the Wind Stats, it's trash. As weak handling, weak cornering, can barely jump, but really, really wants to go fast.
Honestly, that's more to his benefit. He's a bigger guy and tries to stick more towards the grounds to use the best turboing that he can.
Basically has only one good skill. It's going fast.
Yep. There's a difference between min-maxing and generalization. Quite well. I think I still have the carrot.
What?
I think that I still have some of the Excitebike 64 characters via the McDonald's Happy Meal. Toys back when they back when McDonald's remembered what it was.
Back when they remembered Excitebike 64.
Yep. But you know how McDonald's has been raising its prices and cutting a lot of shit? Mm-hmm. Apparently they want to get rid of their soda fountains to prevent free refills. You know how parents used to ask if kids if they had the McDonald's money? Well, parents aren't having McDonald's money, so whoever has cheaper prices than McDonald's is going to have a multi-billion dollar franchise. I'll tell you that much.
sure people won't be really happy with me. Can't have their refills of soda pop.
Here.
See how this is.
What? Watch this. I think this is the... Yeah. I kind of got wrecked by my own actions.
Don't worry, I'm sure I'll be wiping out any segments now.
Nah, you were able to handle yourself a lot better than I was.
There we go. Seems like many modern companies are now going to fail or paralyze. Lose a lot of money because they stopped doing the make drastic change to business, but stopped doing the thing. Starting to do a thing that changes something you thought wouldn't be necessary to worry about. With Unity deciding to charge people for downloads.
Which is why I think we should be able to slap people with a fish. Why a fish?
For funny.
If they do something stupid, they should feel stupid for doing it. In terms of dirt biking, riding along the edge like that is considered in poor form, like you're showing off.
I'm not trying to do that, I'm just
no,
actually drawn to birds.
No, it was just punishing me for doing so. Hey, look, it's the Nintendo logo is in a couple different corners. It's the same logo Conker cuts during Conker's Bad Fur Day. Did you just beat the computer's basic records?
Apparently. I want to try playing the computers on a waste that does.
Go for it.
Doesn't suck. Come in faith. Just come in faith. These aren't just bike colors, they're motorcycle type. At least they look like different models.
They're different brands of dirt bikes.
Talking about being having a full camera in the sun. Having all of these assholes around.
Yeah, some people just fall off their bikes for no damn reason whatsoever. There's a way to jettison yourself off the bike, but...
So far.
Nice. Something tells me that you're...
Bobby Malone is behind the leader. Sarah Hill. Sarah Hill drops back to second place.
No, I don't.
Coming into the last lap, Bobby Moodle has the lead. Sarah Hill is behind the leader.
Nice. Well,
this has been Excitebike 64.
Yep. I hope you found this episode at least somewhat exciting.
Ba-dum-ching.
This has been another lovely episode of Gaming with Shala.
Shala.
We will see all of you on whatever we decide to record next. Thank you for watching and tune in for more. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye now.